Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. The man who murdered an 11-month-old boy will spend the rest of his life behind bars with no chance of parole. Tommy Page said nothing during his sentencing yesterday. In November of 2015, he sexually abused and killed Sean S.J. Sylvester in Alexandria. S.J.'s mother, who was dating Page at the time, came home to find her son beaten and unconscious.
He was a baby. He was 11 months old. He didn't get a chance to do any of the things that he was supposed to.
Tommy not only took my sweet innocent nephew from me and the rest of us, but he has splintered my family and left a void that nothing and no one can fill.
Aside from the prison sentence, a $4,000 fine was added for a falsifying evidence conviction. The man once dubbed the UNH rapist is now out of prison. Gary Fecto was released on parole on Tuesday. He was convicted of stalking and sexually assaulting three female UNH students in the late 1980s and spent nearly 30 years in prison. Fecto will be under the supervision of the Department of Corrections until December 18th, which is the end of his maximum sentence. The man who was slammed into a wall while in police custody is now suing the town of Seabrook. Michael Bergeron is seeking $500,000 in damages. In his lawsuit, he claims he suffered permanent brain damage as a result of the 2009 incident. Surveillance cameras recorded former officer Mark Richardson slamming Bergeron into a wall inside the department. Richardson pleaded guilty to assault and had his certification revoked. Firefighters in Woodstock continue to battle a large forest fire that's burning near the Lost River Gorge. Chief John McKay says the fire started along Kinsman Ridge sometime Monday night or early Tuesday morning. 66 firefighters from five towns and two helicopters have been working to battle those flames. At this time, there's no word on how the fire started. Crews are hoping to have the fire contained sometime today. Well, new today, Hudson police are issuing a warning following a concerning incident there. They say bottle bombs were found on the lawns of two homes in the area of Barbara Lane last week. The bottles contained drain cleaner and aluminum, which can create a chemical reaction that causes the bottles to explode. The Nashua Bomb Squad was called in to get rid of the bottles. Meantime, police in Belmont hope the power of social media will help them return some lost photos. These family portraits were found in the road near Busby Construction on Route 106. Officers hope someone recognizes the family so the pictures can be returned. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.